It's Chewy Cracker. Chewy, okay, guys, it's out, and this is what we've been waiting for. The snow map is out tonight. If you're talking US Pacific Standard Time, Europe, we're going to be waking up early in Europe, 6 a.m. in the UK, 5 a.m. So it's what we've been waiting for, an early start for some of us. It's going to come out on NA and EU, which is exciting, solos and squads. That's interesting because it was just squads on PC, so glad to see it's out in solos as well. And of course, Vikendi will be the only map that's out. It's a 6x6 map. You can throw snowballs in the lobby. Vehicles are going to be a bit slippy on snow and ice, so you're going to have to be extra careful with your driving if driving wasn't hard enough already. Of course, we've got footprints, so you'll be able to track your enemies. Or you'll have to be careful about your own footsteps, so walking up things like roads, for example, before crossing will give you a bit more elusiveness, shall we say, from your enemies. It'll be interesting to see how long they last on console, the footprints, but imagine in later games it's going to be something that you'll be able to pick up through a sniper scope, for example, so you'll know where people are. There's changes to the red zones. They get smaller as the zone gets smaller, so less chance of getting red zoned. It's never really been a major problem anyway. The blue zones changed significantly. So changes to the speed of the blue zone, we'll just have to see how that balances out. And balances and it affects the game feel. Level 3 helmets are back out into the world. And there's an increased amount of level 3 vests. So we're going to have to just try this out, see if it's a bit more like a Sanhok loot spawning or a Miramar. It says that overall item spawn rate is at a midpoint between our maps, so we're just going to have to see how it plays out. And there's more smokes around, which of course you'll be able to use to cover your footsteps. There's a new gun, the G36C, and there's been talk of this having quite high recoil on PC, but again, you know, this has been changed for console, so we're just going to have to see how this feels. The Scorpion, which is like a pistol, mixed between a pistol and an SMG, really. It's, I guess, like a weak Uzi. But again, the ump feels so amazing on Xbox and on console generally that we'll just need to see how this one feels for us, guys. Might be something nice to pick up early on in the game. And of course, being on snow, we have snowmobiles. It's a two-seater vehicle, which will be great for us to race around on the map. And then some quality of life things. The mini-map, players can now further magnify the mini-map. Player order consistency, player order between the lobby and in-game is now consistent, that players will have fixed numbers and colours based on the lobby where when they enter a game. Not sure what that means. Added field of view slider in first person. I don't play FPP, so that won't bother me. And this one's really exciting. Added the graphical setting option for the Xbox One X. So can we make the game look better on the X than it ever has done? You know, a different look and feel, really different look and feel for Xbox One X users versus that of the Xbox One. So you can prioritize frame rate, you can prioritize resolution or keep it dynamic. So that won't be out on PTS from what that reads to me, but excited to see how this one plays out. I'd be definitely go up for more frames per second, I think, but it's again something we get to try out tomorrow on the custom servers, so should be posting a video of that tomorrow. A few gameplay changes to some of the pistols there, trying to balance out the kind of Glock pistol, if you like. Improved the sound options. Again, we're just going to need more testing of all of these options. You can read through them there. You can pause the video and have a view there. Lots of performance changes, lots of changes to reporting, and just a huge amount of bug fixes. So I'm just going to scroll through those bug fixes. You can pause the video, watch them, of course, link to these notes also in the description of this video. Check back tomorrow for our map review. I'll try and get up early and get that out as soon as we can, perhaps even stream a bit of this on YouTube in the morning. That might be the quickest way. So I'll see you there. I'm excited to try it. What are you guys hoping for? What are you most excited about? What are your thoughts on this? And so you play it as well. Drop your thoughts into the video. We can discuss on this video and the next one. And of course, in the Discord, which I have copied a link to also in the description. Anyway, guys, it's here. I'm excited. Let's crack on and look forward to some more videos on the channel with the new map for Kendi. It's exactly what we needed on console. I will see you soon. Like, subscribe, enter the notification squad. Cheers all.
It's Chewy Cracker. Let's give him a smacker on his chewy.